One way to study bodily awareness is to look at patient studies, and that has been done a lot. Another way is to look at the people that are experts in bodily awareness, and that might be called the dancers, for instance, where you could feel that they have, their whole life is about their body and controlling their body. And what is really interesting is when you are dancing, there is this view that maybe you forget your body because you are so much immersed in the music, and just you have music and control of movement, but in between there is nothing. And I guess that's part of also the phenomenology of a bodily awareness, is that the body is almost transparent when we move. When we are really immersed in our action, the body is transparent. When you drive a car, your car is never transparent. Your car is there. It's there, you have to control it. Your body, you don't just, it's there, of course, but you don't really pay attention to it. It's really stay at the margin of consciousness. And I think the more you are focused on what you are doing, and like for instance, like dancing, the more you forget your body. But what is interesting is like for the dancers, if you do bodily illusion with them, then they kind of experience that very strongly, more vividly than most subjects, because they are used to pay attention. During the training phase, at least, they have to pay attention to their body. They cannot forget it. It's when they are dancing on stage, like professional dancers, and they can forget it. But when they are training, they have to look at the mirror and to see how it works and so on. So they are very bodily focused compared to other people.